Oi friends, Rin here. So today we do have a Cookie Run Kingdom Beginner's Guide. Now these are things that you guys should know when you guys start on Cookie Run Kingdom. Now if you guys know these things, you guys will progress faster and more efficiently and obtain more gems. That's all we want, right guys? Obtain more gems and get more cookies. That's all we want. Anyways, if these things does help you guys out, remember to leave a like, do subscribe if you guys have not already, and do share with your friends. Anyways, I hope you guys do enjoy. Okay, so the very first thing that I do want to talk about is re-rolling. Now, you guys need to re-roll if you guys did not obtain really good cookies, preferably 2 or 3, because in the early stages, it does not matter what cookies you have because they are very easy. But as you guys progress through the game, without really good cookies, you guys are gonna get stuck because it gets significantly harder. Now, something to note is that you need espresso cookie. No matter the reroll, you need espresso cookie because that is the best cookie in the game, okay? It doesn't matter what anyone say. Just know that espresso is the best cookie because of the ultimate. Espresso ultimate is a stun cap move, which is damage the whole area and stun every single opponent. Not only is this good in PvP, it's also good in questing and killing monsters because it also stuns every monster in its way, except a few exceptional bosses where boss don't get stunned at all. So espresso is really good at PvP and questing, so it's a must-have cookie. Other than that, you guys should get like also milk, which is one of the best tanks in the game, and you guys should get herb, which is a very good healer in the game. But definitely do reroll if you guys did not get any good cookies, but because it will matter in the long run. Okay, so the next thing that I do want to talk about is doing quests over peer grinding. So what I mean by this is that you guys should prioritize doing your tasks on your far right side tab of the kingdom, because this will help you guys progress through faster and more efficiently throughout the game instead of just clearing the stages of the world. Because if you guys just clear the stages of the world, you're eventually going to get stuck and you guys cannot progress any further. But if you guys do your tasks on the far right side of the kingdom, I get it guys. They are tedious and they're annoying sometimes, but you got to do them because it will help you expand your kingdom, build more things, and obtain more resources to help you guys progress faster. So always do these tasks when they are available. So whether it be 3 bounties, upgrade your castle, send the train away, do some expedition, always do these tasks because it's better to do tasks over just pure grinding. Okay, so the next thing that I do want to talk about is that you guys should always be building wood, sugar cubes, or jelly bean. I'm going to tell you guys right now, they are the most important resources of the game. No matter what you guys are doing, you guys are going to need either wood, sugar cubes, or jelly bean. And when you guys get stuck in the game, it's because of one of these resources or all 3 of them. So whether you guys are trying to build an item for a task, or you guys are trying to clear a path in the world stages and you guys are stuck, it's because of one of these resources, most likely wood that you guys are missing. So always be building these resources. They're the core resources of the game and you guys should always be building them. So if you guys think that 300 wood is enough, no, you guys are probably going to lose that in a day. So always be building them. Log on, accept the wood, and produce more wood. Another thing to note guys is that if you guys are playing and you guys need resources, build X3. Now if you guys are away from the game and you guys want to come back later, build X9 and X20 because you guys would get more resources for more amount of time that you guys are gone. Other than that, keep this in mind. One thing to keep in mind is that you guys should always be using your stamina jelly, okay? So let's say you guys have so much stamina jelly that it passed your limit, and you guys have so much and you guys do not know what to do with it. And let's say that you guys completed everything in normal mode. You got 3 stars on every single stage. Go to dark mode and use your stamina jelly there. Because certain stages in dark mode, they have soulstone that you guys can do every single day. So in dark mode, stages with soulstone, you guys can do it 3 times per day and it does reset the next day. So always be using your stamina jelly because there's no point of saving it because you guys can obtain it over time. Okay, so the next thing that I do want to talk about is that you guys should always be doing arena. So no matter what you guys are doing, go to arena, go check that list and see who you guys can defeat, defeat them, refresh the list, and do some more arena. Now, I'm emphasizing arena is because you guys can get gems from arena and medals. And these medals can exchange for soul stone. And these soul stones can get you guys more epic cookies. And you guys can promote your current epic cookie or get brand new epic cookies. So let's say I'm missing a line of defense and I want milk cookies. By doing arena, I can get the soul stone to get milk cookie. So always be doing arena when you guys can. A tip that I do have for arena is that you guys should go for cooldown reduction. So what I notice in arena is that whoever pulls off their ultimate first wins the match. So you guys should bring a common treasure, which everybody has in the game. It's called Squishy Jelly Watch. Now, it's a common treasure, I get it. It doesn't seem as good as the epic or rare treasure, but it's an epic treasure in disguise for arena because it helps you guys reduce your cooldown for a skill so fast. So go for a cooldown reduction and attack toppings and bring Squishy Jelly Watch and you guys should fly through arena. Anyways, keep that in mind. The next thing I want to talk about is that you guys should always be doing your wish tree, your expedition, and sending off your train. I know it gets tedious because sometimes you guys do not have the materials for the train or the wish tree, and you guys should get them, okay? Like, I'm telling you guys now that you guys should go produce them, complete the wish tree, get all three chests, and then you guys need to do the train. This is important because when you guys are trying to finish a task, like expanding the forest or upgrading your castle, they require these Aurora Brick, Aurora Pillars, and Aurora Compass. And these are the only few ways to obtain them, by doing the train and the wish and expedition. So always be trying to sending off your train. Like, if you guys don't have the material for it, go get it. So always be completing the train, the wish tree, and expedition. It's really important or you guys are going to be stuck. Okay, so the next thing that we are going to talk about is that you guys should only do the world stages and keep progressing. Do not worry too much about getting 3-star on that stage, okay? If you guys are focusing on one stage and you guys cannot get 3 stars for it, you guys are wasting time and it's not worth your hearts and your stamina or whatever you guys want to call it. You guys should keep progressing. Even if you guys get 1 star on that stage, keep going until you guys get to the next world. And then when you guys get stronger, go back to the previous world, then complete all the stages with 3-star, and then you guys can obtain the extra gems that you guys can obtain, the 300, 500, and 700. It's better to progress this way because it's more efficient and faster, so you guys don't have to focus on just getting that 3-star on that one stage. You're just wasting a lot of time, so it's just better to just keep going and come back when you guys are stronger. So keep this in mind. Okay, so the next thing that I do want to talk about is events. Now, events are so good in this game because there's always an event going on and there are so many of them. So if you guys check your top left, there's something called events. And if you guys click on that, there's a whole list of events that you guys can do and they are really easy. But the thing is, there's a time limit to these events. So make sure you guys do them before they expire. So whether it be going on an expedition with a certain cookie, clearing a certain stage, or buying a certain decoration, they are just really easy tasks and you guys can obtain cookie cutters, lots of gems from them, so always be checking events and doing those tasks. The next thing that I do want to talk about is saving your jelly. It's important that you save your jelly for the right cookie. So what I mean is using your jelly to level up cookies that will be on your team. Do not use your jelly to level up cookies that you won't be using at all. Do not make the same mistake that I made. I made a cookie go to level 30 something and I did not use it at all, while the jelly could have gone to cookies on my team to level them up and help them get stronger. And the thing about this is that in the beginning you may think, hey, I have a lot of jelly, I don't have to worry about it, I'm just gonna level up any random cookie. And that is not true, okay? Like, it gets increasingly difficult, and if your cookies are under leveled and do not have the right power amount, you guys will be stuck at a certain stage and you guys will be stuck there for actually a long while until you guys can actually level up these cookies. And these cookies passing level 30 requires a lot of jelly. So conserve your jelly for cookies that will be on your team. Do not level up random cookies. Hey guys, I hope you guys did enjoy the guide. If you guys did enjoy the guide, remember to leave that like, do subscribe if you guys have not already, and share with your friends. And any additional tips that you guys want to let any other players know, leave it in the comments section below. Anyways, guys, I hope you guys did enjoy, and I will see you guys all next time.